Welcome to the video demonstration of our non-invasive glucometer, which is a multi-sensor IoT and ML-based device for diabetes detection and blood glucose monitoring via breath. To develop a low-cost prototype, we have fitted various sensors into a soda sipper cup, which we are using as a simple vacuum-based setup for processing the breath sample. On top of the soda sipper cup, we have fitted a glucose drip pipe to pass the breath sample inside the device in a controlled manner, that is with a constant speed of the breath sample being infused into the device. To start with the demonstration, I'll collect my breath sample by blowing my breath into the balloon and handing it over to my teammate. As demonstrated in the video, we need to blow the balloon to a legitimate size of 6 to 7 inches so that we have an adequate amount of breath sample for processing with our device. To process the breath sample using our non-invasive glucometer, we'll carefully attach the mouth of the breath-infused balloon with one end of the glucose drip pipe, whose other end is attached on top of the soda sipper cup. We will also close the cap of the soda sipper cup and slowly start deflating the balloon, which will allow the breath sample to move into our device at a controlled speed. Parallelly, we can see the change in sensor readings on InfluxDB Cloud interface. As you can observe, earlier the readings were a bit stable, and now they have started increasing non-linearly. We will wait to obtain a peak in the graph and for the readings to get stable. We check this for all the sensors we are considering. Parallelly, the breath sample is slowly being diffused into the device. As you can observe, the readings have started becoming stable now at different maximum voltage values across different curves for different sensors based on their sensitivity. So, at this point, since the sensors have reacted to the maximum extent with the breath sample, we open the cap of the soda sipper cup and mount it with the fan setup to expel the breath sample out of our device and get it ready for the next sample. We can observe parallelly that the curve has started descending now, and we will again wait for it to reach the bottom with a stable voltage. Now, as it has obtained a stable point, we will capture the characteristic curve from here and download the corresponding sensor voltage data as a CSV file. We have obtained the sensor's response to the breath sample, but we also need to capture the body vitals details. So let's get the body vitals recorded. We'll be using the standard digital healthcare devices for measuring the body vitals, such as SpO2, which is the oxygen supply in the blood, heart rate, and blood pressure. Let's start with SpO2 and heart rate. So the pulse oximeter shows the heart rate as 87 and SpO2 as 98. Next, we'll be checking the blood pressure and sitting stably for some time. So we have the blood pressure reading as 138 over 86. So I'll move the sensors data file to the correct directory and run the script for diabetes detection. So it's asking me to enter my name, which is Ritu, age 31, gender female, heart rate 87, BP was 138/86, SpO2 98. So it's asking if I want to have the prick test just to print it on the report. So I'll say no for now, though we'll validate it later. So it's testing using pre-trained hypertuned ML models at the back end, and we have the results. And it says you are likely to have diabetes. Now let's validate the same using the prick test method. So we clean the tip of the finger using an alcohol-based solution, and we'll be pricking the finger with a lancet, and we have a blood drop ready. Now we'll insert the test strip in the device and put the blood drop onto it, and we'll wait for the reading. And we are getting the BGL as 114, which is a borderline or pre-diabetic case. So you can observe that our device is even able to detect borderline cases. And as the readings from both devices are in correlation with each other, we hereby validate that our prototype detects diabetic cases efficiently and can help in the diagnosis of many diabetic cases at an early stage and aid in timely treatment and control. Our device has an accuracy of 96.9% for detecting if a person is diabetic versus non-diabetic, and predicts if the blood glucose level of a person is high or moderate with an accuracy of 98.4%. The portability, low cost, and convenience to use our device makes it an ideal pre-diagnostic tool, especially in areas devoid of proper medical facilities.